You're new here, aren't you?
So? I had a few words with B. Smith. Oh, she's got a nerve, that one.
There's only one place for Smith, under the thumb.
Hope I've got the thumb for it.
What'd he do?
Tampered with one of the girls.
Oh, he'd be hard up.
What did they expect, putting a man in charge of female prisoners? And a man separated from his wife, too.
Like putting Dracula in charge of a blood bank.
Now, look, we don't want her to see the positive side of prison at all.
If you could wear these at all times, please. Identification. They fixed to the lapel, like so.
Oh, who picked the photo?
I did, why?
Oh, Jim, there were half a dozen shots of me. This one's the worst one of the lot.
Well, if it frightens the prisoners, so much the better.
Keep Gillespie out of our hair.
Oh, yeah. Wouldn't mind shooting him.
There's a rifle and cleaning gear in front of all of you. First thing we better do is to strip them down.
What precisely is the object of this? If there's a riot, we break out the rifles, then we pull them apart to frighten the prisoners.
What's the matter?
There might be half a dozen psychopaths waiting to stick knives in our ribs. Hold my hand, Vera.
Don't be ridiculous.
What are you and Smith hatching up between you now? A mass breakout? All right, Burns, you wanted in the governor's office. You've got a visitor.
Who?
Peter Hope. The governor wants to see you in her office, and that's an order.
When will that old rocker learn to leave me alone?
There's no way to talk about the governor.
Mrs. Powell has been made a senior officer.
Ooh!
And when she tells you to do something, you do it. Now!
Would you try not to be too harsh with the women in your attitude? You've always shown them understanding in the past. I wouldn't like you to lose that quality.
Mrs. Davidson, as union rep, I doubt whether my members will agree to such a scheme.
What makes you think now Miss Bennett's gone, things are going to be any easier?
Things couldn't get any worse, Mrs. Powell. Mm.
Well, I wouldn't bank on that.
I would like you to take over as acting chief prison officer, for the time being, at least.
Do remember, though, I had been around for a while. I know you all. Don't try and make a fool out of me.
As if we would.
Would we do that?
Do you know what it means to be up in a charge? It means you lose all of your privileges. And on top of that, you may have extra time to spend in here.
No!
You're going to be sorry you did that for a long time to come. A prison officer.
In view of the extenuating circumstances, I'm willing to drop the charge.
I'm sure you made the right decision.
It wasn't really a decision, was it?
Whatever the rights or wrongs of the situation, you made the right decision.
If you say so, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, I do.
Yeah! Yeah! Oh, shit! Freedom now!
Just arrest that woman. She deliberately attacked me.
You rotten little bitch. Ah!
You sadistic bitch! Now we know how you really work!
Now that's the one I owed you. This one's for now.
I thought we could just get to know each other better.
Colleen, if I didn't know you better, I'd say you were making a pass.
Well, would that be so terrible?
Well, she soon came up with that idea how to get old Po-Face off me back pretty quick.
She'll be laughing on the other side of her face before long.
Yeah, bloody bitch.
And all I've got to look forward to is another day with Colleen Powell.
This isn't a nightclub, Edwards.
Isn't it? Oh, I've come to the wrong place.
Hey, maybe she's the floor show, huh? Boom, boom, Powell. The exotic stripper, huh?
I'd pay to see her. I've got my money back.
Mrs. Powell has been permanently promoted to Chief Prison Officer. Congratulations, Mrs. Powell.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thanks, Mrs. Davidson.
Not Sandy. Not Kate. No. Shut up, the lot of you.
Bloody old Po-Face.
You and I have something to discuss. I want to know everything that's going on in here.
Hurry up, will you? That is, if Edwards doesn't mind.
Oh, no, I finished things. Just shut the door on your way out. Thanks.
Move it! It's not fair!
So, what's going on here?
Smoker?
Oh, very funny, Edwards. It's a little late for one thing. For another, you've forgotten the cigarette.
It's over a week since I heard from my little boy, and I...
Oh, I don't want your life history.
Mrs. Morris, due to personal reasons, was unable to accept the position of deputy governor.
So I therefore have pleasure in announcing that Colleen Powell has been appointed, and I officially offer my congratulations. I'm sure she will do an excellent job.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Colleen. Thanks.
Why aren't you eating, Peterson?
Let's just say I didn't care for the people sitting at my table.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. Someone must have bungled the place cards.
Mrs. Powell, I have a great deal of money.
So?
What's this, the Wentworth Social Club?
We were just discussing their workload.
Short discussion. Peterson, you wanted in the interview room.
How come she gets a visit at this hour?
It's a legal visit, her solicitor. Is that okay by you? May we go?
Yeah, go right along.
Thank you.
Bloody old po-face!
Pat, you remember Meg Morris?
Yes, hello, of course. Pat. Nice to see you again, Meg.
Thank you.
And this is our daughter, Jenny. Jenny, Mrs. Morris.
Jenny.
This one's Robert.
Hi, Robert.
Hi.
Well, you don't think I'd miss out in a few days in the Queensland sun, do you?
But it's their monsoon season.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson gave me permission to make a birthday cake for Bee's surprise party.
A cake? What, sardines, crackers and mushrooms?
It's an old bush recipe.
Put them back.
Oh, you haven't got any heart, Mrs. Powell. You just wait till it's your birthday. We won't even give you a present.
Do me a favour. If you're going to use that recipe, don't make me a cake either.
Shut up, will you? You're crazy!
I just want to find out what you're good for.
No!
You don't even know where your kid is. Or who nabbed her. And look at you, you're here just as usual, giving out orders and
Shut
acting
up,
like me.
You got class, you know that? Real class. You sure know where to stick the knife in. Listen, I don't need support from you. From any of you.
Raped. I'm afraid so, Mrs. Powell.
Oh. Your name is Carol Frances Lewis, is that correct?
Yes.
You are charged with being an accessory to armed robbery, accessory to murder, abduction, accessory to rape, and you are charged with murder. You are to be remanded here until your trial, is that correct?
Yes.
Have you any questions?
No.
No what?
No, Mrs. Powell.
18 months. She abducts my daughter. She stands back while that pig attacks her, and they give her 18 months. At least Jennifer was happy for her. Like a father, wouldn't know what bitterness is. Wish to God I didn't.
Mrs. Powell, I'd like...
Forget it.
I'm sorry.
You know, you could be quite nice, really. If you weren't such a miserable bitch.
Come on, hurry up, smart. This isn't a beauty parlour.
Probably just as well, Mrs. Powell. You'd never hold down the job.
Your time's up.
I think a girl should take time with herself, don't you? For her appearance, I mean. But then again, I guess there are times when nothing works.
Move it. And you have a chance of starting this stint in solitary if you don't shut your mouth.
I've done no more for Barbara than I have for B or Lizzie. So what's the difference?
The difference is that B and Lizzie don't look like Barbara.
You mean I'm not allowed to help the pretty ones?
I mean you're not allowed to help yourself to the pretty ones. Oh, well, tell me I'm surprised.
I've been feeling poorly, Mrs. Powell.
Yes, I'm rather concerned for Miss Latham's health.
I think you should be more concerned about her sex drive. Does Mrs. Davidson know how sick you are?
I don't know, Mrs. Powell. Probably if she's looked at the medical reports.
But what about me poor old joints?
Well, just keep moving and they'll be fine.
You heard? Let's move them back to the laundry. Wonder how Jeff Carlson will react to someone like Joan being issued with a set of Woodridge keys. At least the male prisoners will be safe. I've heard the women refer to you as the gutless wonder. Easy to see why. When I have actual proof that you're in physical danger, I'll consider moving you.
You're gonna wait till you find me bashed up in some corner.
Yeah, that'd probably do it. Hello, what's going on here? Nothing to do, have we?
Smoko, Mrs. Powell, union rules.
Yeah, well, get back to work. My rules. Wipe the smile off your face, Quinn. Still got a full morning's work to do.
What the hell am I supposed to do out here?
Well, you can start by pulling out the weeds.
I wouldn't know weed from a gum tree.
Well, that's easy. If you get a hernia, you've pulled out a gum tree. If she gives you any trouble, just call the gate guard.
And who am I going to call if she starts giving me trouble?
Try me. Hope your lungs are good, though. Don't know where I'll be. Come on, you two. I want you to do a job for me in the library.
The library? Oh, God, I hate books.
Really? I heard a rumour you used to run one.
Yes, Mrs. Powell. Yes, Mrs. Powell. Yes, Mrs. Powell. Listen, I don't like the tone in your voice. Yes, Mrs. Powell.
If you want to spend some time here, I'm sure I can find a room for you.
I'm coming, Mrs. Powell.
Do you want something?
Look, Cole. Please come home.
But it has been 16 years of looking after them, looking after you, the house. What happened to me? Where'd I go?
Really threw you, Patrick, coming to Wentworth today, didn't it?
Yep, it did. God, he could make me so mad I could knife him.
I'll get it.
If it's him, I've gone abroad.
I like you too. Come on. Why don't you stay?
It's tough living in an igloo.
Judy doesn't like us there in our uniforms. I mean, we'd look especially silly with two of us in blue raincoats.
Yes, yes, I forgot. Well, perhaps we could borrow one of Bee's or Lizzie's uniforms. Always like to be dressed for the occasion. I have what it takes to be a prison officer. I certainly don't have what it takes to be a parent.
We're going to polish off this bottle of wine, and then I'm going to let you talk me into spending the night with you.
Been there, done that.
You think you've got it made, don't you? Lock them up and then lay their husbands. What a racket.
Nothing happened last night.
You lying bitch! Chris, aren't you going to say goodbye to Mrs. Powell? Men. Goodbye, Colleen.
Hey, Bee, do you reckon we stop and have a smoko?
No. You won't.
Wasn't Maxine back? I thought she was with you.
Oh, I'm sorry. I should have got your approval first, perhaps. Miss Ferguson's taken her for a visit. Is that all right for you?
We've always had far less trouble from the women when they've been treated more humanely.
Well, that's not quite true, Meg. Well, I think allowing them to wear makeup was a huge mistake. Look at them. Half of them look like tarts.
Half of them are.
If they want realism, let them sneak back in a month when everything will be back to normal.
Shut up, Mackenzie. Look at that. No, honestly, I'm not a prude, but I don't think that's even possible. I mean, Kennedy's sex life, that's one thing. Birdsworth's spelling, that's in a class of its own. Can't stay here all day. I left Joan Barfield in charge. Been here before. It's not bad. Shouldn't imagine Joan has, though.
Well, at least we'll get to know what she's like outside Wentworth.
Oh, my God. I'd hardly consider that one of the high spots of my life. What do you suppose she eats? Raw meat?
Lunch, Mrs. Reynolds. Don't bother putting it down. Perhaps someone else would like it.
But what about your lunch? Mrs. Davidson always had it about this
time. Mrs. Davidson. Now, please take it out.
I wouldn't worry about Lizzie if I were you. She was giving Mrs. Davidson advice all the time.
Once again, Mrs. Powell, and I think I'll have to put a memo out to this effect. I am not Mrs. Davidson. Now, I'll be at Driscoll House if anyone wants me.
Last time I shot you lunch, lady.
I mean, just think of the time you put in trying to find a housekeeper for Chris Young.
She knows all about Chris.
But how?
I won't mention any names. I'll just give you the initials. Joe bloody Ferguson. Can you imagine what's going to happen if those two team up together? I'll spell it out for you. We are going to be R.S.
Well, there was no need to inform on a fellow officer.
Oh, I am sorry. I keep forgetting how close we all are.
I'd like to remind the bitch with a sledgehammer.
You mean she was trying it on?
Yes, she was. And if you persist in undermining my authority with both the officers and the... Oh.
Mrs. Powell! Mrs. Powell!
I overreacted a little.
It's the Irish in me. Moonbeam, your solicitor's here to see you.
What, now?
No, last week.
How long do you think I'll be, Mrs. Powell? About half an hour?
I haven't the faintest idea. Could you get out? Come on, Meg. I know you're worried about Bea and Lizzie, but there are other prisoners to think about.
Hello, Mickey.
I'm looking forward to seeing what it's really like in here. Oh, I'm sure if I was locked up day and night, I'd have problems too.
She's just finished a sociology degree.
Oh, well, that's going to be a big help to her in a new job.
Can I have a look around?
Oh, please. Hunt Birdsworth, I need you for cleaning duties.
Oh, terrific. Nobody cares about an old lady with a weak heart.
You'll see me out.
And if it is psychologically induced, she's going to need a psychiatrist. And in my opinion, not just for her legs.
Thank you, ma'am.
Come on. Let's go, ma'am.
I am Joan. I must return to my men and do battle for the glory of France.
Joan of Arc?
Oh, yeah, that's all we need.
The bells, they are calling me!
You just stay there and rest. You'll need your strength for the battle.
The Archangel Michael is waiting for me.
That's all right, I'll phone him.
Paul, I came to see if there was a letter for me.
Oh, not unless it came through a time warp.
Time warp?
I've heard. The King of France's carrier pigeons. They're all dead. Nice to see you made it, Mason. Unfortunately, we don't allow customers in here unless they're properly dressed. It is a shame, but you're going to miss breakfast. Bye-bye.
But...
No buts. Get out.
They had these big silver laser guns and they went zap and my hair turned red. Well, Mars is the red planet, you know.
Well, zap. Let's go.
Back to the Martians?
To the showers. Get out.
It'd be nice to have them all programmed into a computer.
The staff are the only computers around here. The way I feel today, my silicone chip's cracked.
Listen, you've got to warn the governor there's a bomb in there, and there may be more in the prison.
You and Dr. Collins are engaged.
Yes, isn't it wonderful? Mrs. Reynolds, you could be matron of honor. And
Mrs. Powell, take her back to the laundry.
I hope you haven't ruined my chance to be flower girl. Stevens, report to reception. You've got a visitor.
Oh, another one? That makes two in 2 days.
Good girl. You can count. Mind your own business and get on with it.
Get yourself something nice because Foxy's only used to the best, you know.
Yes, so you keep telling me. No, it's all right. I've darned my stockings. I pulled out all my best clothes so he won't smell them off balls.
Oh, good on you, Mrs. Powell.
It's a lovely day for a drive, though. Isn't it, Colleen?
I beg your pardon. Hello, I'm Colleen.
You don't have to tell me who you are, darling. You're the spitting image of your mum.
I think this calls for a little drink.
I need a drink.
Oh, well, let's have another drink first. It'll look all the better.
Definitely not. You know how it disagrees with you, Mother?
I'm just going to powder my nose.
I'll come with you.
Oh, no, Meg will come, thank you, dear.
It's no trouble, Mother. You're late, Stevens. This isn't a luxury hotel, you know.
I've never been confused about that, Mrs. Brown.
What's this? A union meeting?
No, I think it's a tea break.
But then, you are the governor.
Thank you. Knew you hadn't forgotten.
Stay there, I'll get help.
You'll never let the stupid bitches on the road.
Listen, wait a minute, I'll give you my name and address. Just a minute.
I reckon he's dead.
If I could drag you away from your paper, please.
Oh. See, there was a hit and run just down the road from the prison yesterday. Some old drunk copped it. I saw you kill that old man.
What's your problem, lady?
Sorry, I didn't... It's just that I thought you were someone else.
Sure you did. Well, baby, we're all the same in the dark.
With any luck, Miss Ferguson should be out on her neck in no time flat.
I'll drink to that. Excuse me. It was a hint, not an old saying.
Gin?
Anything. Don't worry about a glass, just a straw.
Joan has resigned.
What did they use, a blowtorch?
Don't you push me around, you great lucky bitch!
You know what the real problem is, though, don't you, Sergeant? 9 times out of 10, you bring them back. Anne gets the kudos and the salary, and I do all the dirty work. Well, she's got another thing coming.
Hey, what is this?
Look, either she is fit enough to do this job, and that means all of it, or she can find herself another whipping boy. I've had it, and the bloody job. And the sooner she knows about it, the better.
I'm glad you won't be moving. Don't think I'd fancy running this place without your support.
We're not running a nursery school. All right, then, why don't you just hand them the keys of the prison and let them come and go as they please? I am looking for a new job, and as soon as I find one, you and Anne can have this whole place to yourselves.
Here I am! Mrs. Powell, I'm sorry.
All right, that's it, Parker. You're on a charge, so you can forget about the trip.
I don't believe she'd hurt a fly intentionally.
Well, perhaps flies don't upset her as much as people do.
But if you're going to sulk around this place just because I came back to the job, then you can get out. Because otherwise you'll just get in the way and be a bloody nuisance. Now, what is it going to be?
What the hell's your father doing?
He's looking for his cigarettes.
Darling, tell him to hurry up, will you? He knows he's got to leave plenty of time to get you kids to school in Mr. Manning's car.
Oh, well, listen, can you just give Jenny your car keys? Pat's in a bit of a hurry to get to
All right, there you go, Jen. Looks like we'll have to meet each other some other time, eh?
Bye, sir. Go on, off you go. Have a good day. See you tonight, Pat.
Okay, love. I've left the keys in the car. Come on, Jen.
What?
Patrick!
No!
Someone went to a lot of trouble putting that bomb in your car. So keep your nose out of it, or you won't be so lucky next time.
Lucky? Do you know what you're saying? Do you know what happened out there? My husband and children were in that car, and all you can say is that he was lucky. They've just murdered my family.
Colleen, it shouldn't have even happened!
I didn't get the chance to look at them. I didn't know I wasn't going to see them anymore.
Help me, Meg. I'm not falling to pieces or anything, but I'm having trouble. I don't understand what's happened.
What am I gonna do?
I think it's true, you know.
What?
Well, what they say about drinking to help you forget does work. Wonder if there's any truth in the old story of a hair of the dog to fix a headache.
I wouldn't think so.
We'd like to offer our sympathy.
I appreciate that. But I'd prefer that you concentrated on filling the quota. Come and get them.
Look at you. Your whole family gone.
Shut up.
I'm sorry.
You just leave it, will you?
You better have this back. I mean,
We wouldn't want you getting caught with it, so I put it in a safer place in your pocket, eh?
I just confiscated that. How dare you take it?
I take it that is yours.
Oh, Gaffney, you know, I really didn't think I would miss you. I was right. Excellent. Two crosses. You are improving.
They're not crosses. They're kisses. I love the place.
Showers.
Well, do you ever remember Gaffney having a visit from a sister?
No, I don't.
Right. Where's she been hiding herself these last 4 or 5 years?
Oh, well, if she is anything like Gaffney, hopefully under a rock.
Easy night?
Oh, well, no riots. Oh, God. Now look what I've done. Sorry.
Make it sound as though we jump into bed at every available opportunity.
Well, I hope you do. I'd like to think I was doing double shifts for a worthwhile purpose.
Lock them in their cells, cancel all their privileges, and before we knew where we were, we had a riot on our hands.
It sounds like we've got a riot in here. What's wrong?
Oh, Joan doesn't agree with the strike agreement.
Well, she knows how to make an exit. Jonathan is two-timing you. And I would say he's a bastard. Come on, back to your cells.
Oh, but now, Mrs. Powell.
No, 5 minutes ago. Come on, ladies.
Mrs. Powell, please, can't we watch this program? It's about Hannah.
I reckon Po-Face is going soft in her old age.
Don't bet on it.
The Webbs decided to settle in cash. That's the balance.
$63,000. I've just handed in my resignation. Paris! Rome, the Greek islands. I am going to see as much of the world as I possibly can. What do you think?
I'm too stunned to think.
So was Anne. Well, if there's one thing guaranteed to make trouble at Wentworth, it's your being made deputy governor again, Joan.
And why is that, Mrs. Powell?
Because you are the most deceitful, overbearing officer I've ever come across. You don't give a damn about these women or anybody, and you show it with every move you make.
So what more can I say? She's been a good friend and a pleasure to work with, and we'll all miss her.
To Colleen.
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 Good luck. Listen, thanks. I'm sorry.
Don't worry, you've still got some in your glass, or am I going to cop that too?
What?
It's typical of you, isn't it?
I don't believe this.
And I don't believe all of this. You've made your feelings perfectly clear. I won't impose on you any further.
Not bad, am I?
Carl's turn
server.
Hannah, what is it?
Must finish the tourist work. The Jew has been found. And now you are going to help me kill her. Open it before you both get it. I don't care, Smith. She won't get away this time. Open it. Move! Or she gets the first bullet.
He means that.
Don't move, any of you.
You've had a pretty exciting last day too, haven't you?
Yeah, one I won't forget in a hurry.
Oh, you're so brave tackling that awful man like that.
You let him go in there for a minute.
Well, I think you all kept your cool remarkably well. But perhaps after this little run-in, I won't miss Wentworth too much after all.
Oh, but we'll miss you, won't we?
You sure will.
Yeah.
Thanks, Pixie. Okay, ladies, bye. Good luck. And, try to keep out of trouble.
Oh, Mrs. Powell. Goodbye, good luck, and thanks for everything.
Yeah, that goes for all of us.
Yeah, it sure does.
Thanks.
Bye.
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 Never thought the day had come that I could say I'd miss this place. But I suppose I will.
I know. Grows on you, doesn't it?
Yes. Like warts.
I heard one of them say that this place won't be the same without old Po-Face around.
Well, it's a charming epitaph, isn't it?
bloody old po-face.